Hallelujah. That's your amen. I'll put you outside. I say hallelujah. Stand up on your feet. Just 1 minute. Wave to Jesus if you love him. Outside, inside, just wave to him. Let's tell him how much you love him. We love you. We love you. We love you. We love you. Lift up your voice and just worship God in the main and tell him how much you love him. Tell God how much you love him. Lift up your hands and just wave to him. Believe him. Believe him. We bless you. We give you praise. We give you glory. Worshiping, just tell it thank you. We give you glory, Lord, as we worship you. We give you honor, Lord, as we worship you. You are wonderful. You are worthy. Oh, you are wonderful. You are well. Oh, we give you glory, Lord, as we honor you. We give you glory, Lord, as we worship you. You are wonderful. You are worthy. Oh Lord, you are wonderful. You are worthy. We give you honor, Lord, because the eyes of you love him. As we worship him, we give you glory, Lord, as we worship him. You are wonderful. You are worthy. Oh, you are wonderful. You are wonderful. Oh. You are wonderful. You are worthy. Oh Lord. You are wonderful. You are well. Oh, he touched me.
Touch me.
He touched me.
He touched me.
I know. What the joy,
what the joy
that fills my soul. Something,
something
happens in I know.
I know.
We touch me. Any me, me, Jesus touch me,
he touch me,
the Lord touch me,
he touch me, he touch me,
and I well the joy I face my soul. Something,
something
happened,
happened.
And I know
touch me, enemy, amen. Emmanuel, 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 Emmanuel. Your name is God.
Your name is God.
Emmanuel. 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 Emmanuel, Emmanuel, your name is God.
Name is God.
Emmanuel. Aye, 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 aye,
aye.
Oh, I
am.
Oh, 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 I
am.
Oh,
I
am. Ay, 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 ay.
I am. I am.
I am. I am. I am. I am.
I am. I
am.
I am.
Oh, 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 oh.
I am.
Aye, 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 aye,
aye, aye, aye,
aye, aye, aye, aye, aye,
aye,
aye,
aye,
aye, aye, aye, aye, aye,
aye, aye,
close your eyes, whatever you are, just worship him. Thank you, Jesus. Just worship him, give him praise. Give him praise, give him praise, give him praise, give him praise. See his glory. See his glory. Glory come down as he brings his name forever and ever. See his glory come down. See. In my life, you gotta see his glory. See his glory. See his glory come down as we praise his name. Forever and ever, see his glory come down.
See his glory come down.
See his glory,
his glory
come.
Sit down, whatever you are. Have a seat.
She's glory.
Yahweh. Oh, 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 Yahweh. Oh, oh, Yahweh. Oh, oh.
Yahweh, 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 Yahweh. Oh, Yahweh. Oh, Yahweh. Oh, oh, yeah. Hallelujah. I say hallelujah. For those of you who understand God, who really, really, really want to know some reasons in your life, you know, this thing I'm about to say, the Holy Spirit was able to talk to me peacefully. Not to shout it, not to make noise of it, not to yell of it, or to talk it peacefully. Today, I will not be briefly telling you, you know, inspiring things, but I will be giving you corrections. Say corrections. And I'll be giving you correction. I'll be giving myself correction. And I believe, I pray to God, and I ask God to really communicate through me, so that when someone hear this reason why they have been to God on so many occasions and they haven't getting result, they will get to understand the reason why. Say, I hear you. In John chapter 9, look at the Bible. 31 to 38. Okay, let's just read 31. Now we know that God heareth not what? We know. Say it again. Now we know. Thank you. Now we know that God heareth not sinners. But if any man be a worshiper of God and do his will, he what? 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 If you don't want to know, fine. If you choose not to know, it's up to you. But the Bible says now we know. And you must be part of the we know. Now there is a question in the body of Christ. A question. A very big question in the minds of Christians. A question that many of us have been asking for years. A question that has been very difficult to have an answer. It's what I'm going to share with you today. Hallelujah. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, I studied my Bible and I got to know that in life, one of the things that sustain you on the face of the earth is prayer. Hallelujah. What sustain you on the face of the earth is what? Is prayer. Prayer is asking for God divine intervention. Hallelujah. Asking for God divine intervention into humanity. I'm not talking to somebody here. Asking divinity to visit humanity. I told you before, I said prayer is keeping in communication and keeping in touch with God. Prayer helps to stay your relationship with God. Are you here? Yes. But ladies and gentlemen, many God's children are praying and they are not getting answers. Many God's children. Many Christians are praying. Many pastors are praying. Many mothers, many prophets, people who know God, they are praying and they are not getting answers. And I want to share with you why people are praying and they are not getting answers. Say, I hear. What I'm about to say, I promise to not yell. What I'm about to say. What I'm about to say, it may not look well. It might bring heat in your body. My feet are going outside. But I'd like you to know you're still welcome. Amen. But I feel like I should talk this thing to you. The last time we almost prayed, last week, Tuesday, my father program, when we were praying, I had this message. And when I had this message, and then the Holy Spirit began to give me some analysis and relate to what I'm about to tell you. And he told me to come and say it. And I begin to plead with him, asking. I said, I need backing. I need time. I really want to create a place to understand what I would say if even there will be a regeneration of one pressing, or there will be a restoration of somebody's conscience, or there will be a restoration of somebody's life. It will be better. Amen? I have some dangerous prayer that I want us to pray. But before we pray this prayer, I want to share this thing with you. Number one, if you study the Bible from where we read, the Bible says, now we know that God heareth not sinner. Now we know. And I can tell you for free, what I noticed here in our days of Christianity, what we practice is what we're preaching. Whatever we have not come to the place of overcoming, we don't preach it. You're not a preacher. One of the greatest messages that preacher may escape in the Bible is a message called sin. One of the messages in the Bible that a Christian will not want to listen to anytime you talk about sin. There is a place in the Bible, I'll read it to you. Obadiah 1:17. The Bible says, upon Mount Zion, there shall be deliverance. Anytime you see a prayer person or a pastor or whoever want to read that identical part of the scripture, there is a place they read hard. And there is a place they come down low. Upon Mount Zion, there shall be deliverance. That is a high level. But it didn't stop there. Upon Mount Zion, there shall be deliverance and there shall be holiness. Or anytime it reached to the place called holiness, just skip it. And the house of Jacob shall possess their possession. In the house of Jacob, there are people who want to possess things, who want to have things, who want to live a good life, a worthy life, who want to be delivered, but don't want to live a rightful life. Too many people, can I say that this? Too many wrongful people are calling the rightful God. And in life, the longest we will stay in wrong life, the destined God will be for us in right life. The longest time you are going to maintain your sin, you are going to maintain your attitude, the distance God will always go from you. Are you getting what I'm saying? Yes. Now, ladies and gentlemen, God, according to the Bible says God don't hear sinners. He's a Christian. But according to our understanding, what we know is that God only hears pastors. No. What we know is that, that's why there are many people who today claim it as pastors, when they want to eat your money, when they want to take your things, they feel when they sit in pastor position, they can do anything, they can take any advantage. The feeling is that they are the one God hears. No. But ladies and gentlemen, to make things easy for you and I, we pray, we asking God, but we should ask ourselves, why is it say that God is not hearing our prayer? So why? I've been praying over one thing for 5 years. I've been praying over one thing for 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, 6, 7, 8 years. Why am I struggling over this one thing? Over, over, over. And I can't get the answer. Why? And there are times when we pray, we ignore our fault and prioritize our problems. You get that one. You get that one. You get that one. When we pray, what do? We ignore our faults. We ignore our personal attitude. We ignore our ways. And we prioritize our problem. When we get to church, what do? Our problem becomes emotional. Emotional. When the pastor preaching, see you crying, cry, cry, die, cry. Ooh. There are times when you raise your prayer and you are praying. Who said the pastor must say, God, I want you to pray this evening that whoever that has stolen your helper, let them bring it back. See you now. Oh, apostle. You long been preaching, but whoever has stealed my helper, you start to cry as ugly as you are like me. Yeah. That your cry, no water coming down, but you are crying. You are making noise. You say, that way where people were at, they were acting the way they prioritize our problems and ignore our conscience. Ladies and gentlemen, whenever you ignore your conscience, you will never feel wrong in life. I say that again. Why we don't see the move of God in our time? Too many wrong people are asking a right God. If you maintain your wrong life, if you maintain your wrong living, the longest time you want to spend in your sin, the longest time God will stay from you. Watch this. If you study the Bible, he said, God, yeah. God can, yeah. Don't let nobody fool you. A time of problem, and never feel like there is no God. A time of situation, make us to feel there is no. I promise I'm not going to shout today. Okay. I need help. Are you here?
Yes.
Yes. That's what happened to us at time. We are promised. Oh God, I need your help. Oh God, I need to come in. Oh God, I beg you. Oh God, I need deliverance. But hear this very carefully. The Bible says God can hear. But when you are fasting and you are praying, when you have gone to churches, you have saw men of God, you have given seed, you have put offering, you have done all manners of things, and yesterday there is no answers to your prayer. Ladies and gentlemen, who is at fault? The pastor is not at fault. The problem here in our life, most often when we discover that we pray fast, and we not get the answer, you must understand God hears. But God don't hear sinners. And we live in a world where today people take Christianity to be purity. Christianity is a name. But the true Christianity is a lifestyle. You can choose to bear the name on you and don't live a life. And if you bury the name Christian and you're not living a life as a Christian, you'll be a mockery. Those are the Christian and people mock. And you'll be saying, oh, what are they saying? Where is my God? You won't get no God. The first thing you should know, according to the Bible, you know, our lives, if God must hear us when we pray, run from sin. You have to run from sin. Run from sin. Escape from sin. Do all you can to escape sin. Because God don't hear sinners. God hear those who worship him and those who do it his will. God don't hear sinners. Hallelujah. Amen. If you study the Bible very carefully, as I begin to study my Bible, I understand. I really wanted to know that if we pray and we're not getting the right answers to our prayer, what are the reasons that we are not getting answers to our prayer? What are the problems? I want us to look at some scriptures here. If you read the Bible in John chapter 19, verse 31, the Bible says, for we know that God heareth not sinner. So once you are a sinner, no matter how long you pray, God will not hear you. So you could be a Christian in public and a sinner in private. So we got to understand here, one of the reasons why many people are serving God and they are not receiving the benefit of God, number one, be not deceived, for God is not more. I will say the clear truth to you, whatever you sow is what you reap. So in life, you can never come on the popular scene and do drama. You can come in and mess up people. That's what there are many people today. They get money on their way out.
They can't find their way in. They are not going nowhere. They are not doing nothing. Nothing happening for them. Because they are properly God's servant and they are private sinners. And ladies and gentlemen, in the public is where men know you, but in the private is where God sees you. And I'd like you to know that God don't reward people that pray openly. God reward people that pray privately. Privately. When I'm saying God reward people that pray privately, it's in a sense here that in life, once you go to church, many people will say, oh, I've been carrying one problem here. From place to place, I've gone to man of God, let my trouble can go. When they take tester and put it in your vein, and a small cause you can cause. When they put tester in you, when they examine you, and a small rule you rule. When they examine you, people can't sleep in the community because of you. When they you are running around from men of God to men of God. From men of God to men of God is not the problem. The problem here, if your way pleases God, you have to find means to make your way. People that are chasers of men of God, they don't want to be right with God in yourself. If you continue to chase after men of God, God will raise up most false prophet to eat your money. Public worshiper and private sinners. Are you here? Are you here? Ladies and gentlemen, God don't watch the things we do in public. No. No, no, the things we do in the private, God sees. And some writers say God is watching from a distance. I come to a place in my life, I study my Bible every day. No member, no parliament, no ushers, no protocol will come to me and say, Apostle, I'm honored as your grace here, but I'm being disgraced. I know what you do in the private, and I know that. All of us meet here, we serve here, and when you go home, and I'm behind you. And I'm with you. And in life, God reward a man according to his heart. Are you getting what I'm saying? Are you getting what I'm saying? Are you getting what I'm saying? Most men today that are praying, most pastors today that are praying, ladies and gentlemen, the people we pray for today only because we want money, have God revealed to you their lifestyle. It's not everybody that go to you and you just go on mountain for them. It's not everybody that go to you and you just start praying. No wonder why pastors do commercial. They collect money, they fast and pray for people. Most of the people we fast and pray for are people that do sex fume. They go at night. Men and women go at night, naked themselves, expose their private part on videos. When we walk out, we need to raise up our conscience. You cannot be living that kind of life in your room, doing all kinds of nastiness. And you come before the presence of God and you are asking for what? My God, we pray for less PM, we don't know. We pray for gays, we don't know. We pray for nasty people who are not ready to change. As far as we're concerned, when they bring their prayer plan with their money, we collect it and pray for them. But their life is not in line with what they're asking for. And ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the truth God to be revealed. It's time for the truth God to be revealed. It's time for the truth God to be revealed. If God must answer you, you got to change your lifestyle. You say amen, I am talking to you. Shout out, hallelujah. Many of us go to churches, we carry problems, we see pastors, but we tell them how foundation chasing us. We tell them how witchcraft in our family, but we don't tell them we sleep on phone doing all kind of nastiness. We don't tell them that we are this, we are that. We don't tell them the personal thing we do. We don't tell them that a pastor, they take you 40 days, no answer, 80 days, no answer. Don't you know you are praying for a lesbian or a gay who's not willing to change? but God don't hear sinners. God can hear. Am I talking to somebody here? I say, am I preaching to somebody here? God can hear. Let's see. That no answer, no ballet until that. You serve in what a lot of entire go. And you tire worshiping God. No ballet problem situation can make me feel there is no God. If you start your being, I know your private this. I don't know your private behavior. I don't know. But if your way pleases God, God watch you every minute, every second, every hour. God see all your day-to-day activity. You now take everything and you place it on foundation. But when it comes to last time, you are nasty. Very nasty. Very nasty. When it comes to last time. But you are there. You are there. You are there. You are there. No wonder why when you drop the nightmare, you will come back. No wonder why when you drop the nightmare, she will come back. No wonder why when you drop the demon, they will come back. Because, ladies and gentlemen, what a trap sickness, sin. What a trap problem, sin. Anywhere you see sin, you always see trouble. I'm not going to somebody here. There are people when they get a church, as I'm talking now, when they get a church, when you see them, when you're going from pastor, you see like a holy angel. Hey, pastor, as I'm talking to you, you don't know what's going on in my life. I wish you know. I wish you know. I wish you just know what's going on in my life. Finish rule. I wish when you finish praying for them, you pour oil on your head. Drive behind them. Go see them display. Go see them display. Go see them. There are people today who's saying there is no God. There is God. Nobody can make me to feel there is no God. There is God. Say there is God. Say there is God. You cannot be living a wrong life and you are asking God to give you the right thing. It's not possible. It's not possible. I'm not talking to somebody here. I'm not talking to somebody here. You say amen. God will deliver you today. Shalaya!
Maya!
Shalaya!
Maya!
What is the definition of sin? Sin is described in the Bible as transgression against the law. The biblical definition of sin, transgression against the law. Wrong in nature. Breaking the law, transgression against the law of God. What is sin? The definition, the biblical definition for sin, rebelliousness, being rebellion, very rebellion. And ladies and gentlemen, I want us to look at a few scriptures here. I want to give them to you, and then we'll move on. First John chapter 3, verse 4. First John chapter 3, verse 4. Can you hear me with that? First John 3, 4. First John 3, 4. God don't hear us sinners. No. He don't hear us sinners. God don't hear Cheche Pole. God don't hear Bisabole. He don't hear gossipers. No, 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 no. Whosoever committed sin. Whosoever committed sin. Read your Bible. Whosoever committed sin. What? Transgress also the law. For sin is the what? For sin is the what? Sin is the breaking of the law. I wish I was preaching here. I said, I wish I was preaching here. First John chapter 3, verse 4. There are many people say, oh, you know, Jesus came and died for me, and now I am saved. There is no condemnation to them that are in God. I am under grace. I am not under the law. No problem. No problem. But if you read Romans chapter 6, the Bible will tell you. He says, shall you continue to remain under grace that sin made about? Will you continue in your grace? Grace? Thank God for the grace generation. Thank God for the grace. Because of grace, we are doing nastiness. Because of grace, we are living a nasty life. Because of grace, we have... In fact, Christ need to come and die for the fifth time. Before you now go to heaven. Jesus, because grace has poured the whole thing. Shall we continue to walk in sin that grace may abound? But we're not on the law. You know, in the days of Moses, when you do anything, they will stone you, they will kill you, they will destroy you. But these days now, we are under grace. We are under grace. So you can just do anything because you honor grace. So because you honor grace, no right life. Because you honor grace, no good life. Because you honor grace, no better life. Because you are a child of grace. Grace. Grace now spoil the Christian setup. More grace. 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 You taking your shopping set, you going with that grace. You cutting your 2-3 hair and that grace. Grace has erased conscience. Because of grace today, people do things. And they say, we are under the grace of God. So people go now, they sit down, they champagne, and they depend on grace. People do all kind of immoral things. We have an immoral life. Live any kind of life. And we are there saying, ah, my father, as I begin to pray, came my enemy, 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 my hey. Are you angry? Why are you saying no like that? Are you angry? You're not standing well. You're not standing well. You're not standing well. Are you here?
Yeah.
Are you here?
Yeah.
You don't want to come to World of Life again. See you. Don't come by here. Bye bye. Have a nice day. You put your offering. I wonder what I want to ask for. You put your offering. Leave. Am I talking to somebody here? Am I talking to somebody here? In Isaiah 38, in verse 1, Isaiah the prophet went to Hezekiah. He said, Hezekiah, the Lord sent me to you. The Lord said, I should tell you, if you don't put your house in order, you will die. If you don't put your house in order, you will die. Ladies and gentlemen, in those days was Hezekiah said unto them, and Isaiah the prophet, the son of Amon, came unto him and said unto him, thou said the Lord, set the house in order. Set the house in order. Ladies and gentlemen, today in our generation, what we study is that by the grace of God, we believe God for miracle, we believe God for blessing, we believe God for breakthrough. But we study in John chapter 8, the Bible said there was a woman committed, caught in adultery. She committed adultery. They brought that woman to Jesus. The Bible says Jesus tried to stand for her. Jesus preached at the grace of God. And when Jesus stood for her, that they didn't stone her to death. But after the people left from around the woman, and Jesus said to her, woman, where are your accusers? But after her, many people don't see the other part of it. They only say, oh, Jesus saved the woman from being stoned. Jesus didn't just save the woman from being stoned. He said to the woman, go and see no more. What do you want to say? You want to say Jesus a sponsor for sin? Or grace a sponsor for sin? No. Is grace the father for sin? No. Is grace the uncle for sin? No. I know you commit adultery. That'll tell you in life when you wake up, you wake up. When you get up, you get up. I can tell you for free why God not answering many of us today. We got to visit the private thing we do. We got to visit the private thing we do. We got to visit the private thing we do. If you cannot visit the private thing you do, go to Baba. I suggest. Go to Muslim. You think God is a mathematician? God is not a mathematician. God is a dieting. God is not a mathematician. He's the Holy God. He's the rock of ages God. He's a God of all perfection. When you will change now? When? For more 8 years you are in church. You're not doing no better. Nothing about you changing. From church to club, church to entertainment center, church to talking, church to gossip. It's like being in church. The thing you do outside has already eaten you up. So there are many of us who just come to church to be among the numbers. But we're not ready to leave attitudes. We're not ready to leave behavior. We're not ready to leave anything. But as I'm talking now, you're just hustling in your whole life. You're not ready to leave nothing. You're just hustling where you hear solution. Anywhere you hear say, oh, they can take a jika from people toe, you're running. They can take a jika from people tea, you're running. You now you don't want to change. I hear a testimony or they say God giving job. What kind of trouble here? Eh? I hear a testimony, but you know, I've been going all around. You know what changed that? I'm not with somebody here. Okay, now listen. If you study the Bible very carefully, the Bible will tell you for each time a man receives the grace of God, you don't go back taking back this because I'm playing. You don't go back taking back in the same thing. Many people get a problem, you know, but you know, we as me, for me as a minister of God, I don't waste my time on looking at any kind of issue. I will share about this with you. Many people got a problem and say, this pastor went here, he prayed here, and people got healed, listen, you know, and they went back to the sin sickness. I will share something with you today. Many people say, in fact, they accuse BB preacher. BB preacher around the world. People come to you, they help you. They help you, pray for you. You come out of the problem. Then you say, but what kind of man of God? I notice anytime you pray for people, they'll go back to the same problem. Let me tell you, when they pray for you and you go back to your ways, you attract the problem. You, as soon as you go back to your ways, you go back to your problem. No, let me see that one. You know, that prayer, yeah? Not correct prayer. This prayer, that demonic prayer. This prayer, that medicine prayer. Because medicine healing can't lie. It's not medicine. Check the Bible. Everyone that Jesus ever healed, he warned them. My friend, sin no more. What kind of Bible can read? That Quran you read in the Bible or the book of Mormon? Anytime Jesus healed people, he tell us to go and sin no more. You 12 years alcoholic. And they not pray for you, not drinking again. After 2 years, you can't go to church. You go back in the bottle. The demon are coming. Can I tell you something? The Bible tell you, and he said, when a demon leave a man, he goes on a dry place. The demon is angry. Now, I like you to know that demons don't possess people until something attracts it. And one of the things that attract demons and evil spirit, filthy life. Filthy life can attract demons. A lot of people can say, I get nightmare. Filthy life. You sleep with 8 men, how you can get nightmare? Oh! We're gonna trouble here. You sleep, you're one. You sleep with 8 different men. And you feel a pattern and a passion or a faction. You will get nightmare. I told you earlier, what attract demons? Sin. Demon, sin. What is sin? Sin is dirtiness. Anywhere you see dirt, you see fly. If I laugh, go to West Point. Fly. I will tell you for free. If you live in a lie, you are not problem free. You need self-visitation. You live a lie from problem to another problem, from problem to another problem, then you are passing from pastor to pastor. No! Drop some activity out of your life. It's just all the issue. Many people say, the man of God pray for me, the sickness come back. There are people, the reason why God put big nut here, so they can start drinking liquor. Because the more your throat clear, the more you water. So when God put a nut here to close your throat from taking liquor. When you drink water, you're free. But then you put alcohol, it will burn you. You see that? Then all of a sudden, you're fortunate to be healed from it. Being healed from it does not give you the right to return back to it. You will not return. Am I talking here? Am I talking here? Listen. Help me. Come, mama. Come. Come quickly. They won't go for an interview, right? Sorry. Oh? She go for an interview, right? Knee down. Say, Daddy. Say, I won't pass my interview.
I won't pass my interview.
You go my interview? Yeah. Bring me one. My daughter won't pass the interview. Bring me one. Hurry. We won't get time. Bring me one. Watch this. Alright? The oil placed on the woman is a sign of purification. It's a sign of sanctification. Watch her. She's going for an interview 5 in the morning at the embassy. Okay? Now, she came like this. Once the oil is not on her, God has not recognized her. But when the man of God pray for her and anoint her, the oil has come on her. The oil attracts the spirit of God on her. So once the oil comes on her, the anointing of God comes on her. Okay, now she's anointed. She goes to the embassy tomorrow. The anointed beautiful woman here. Get up. All right. Now, Washo, pastor has taken his energy. Giddy giddy giddy. Zuku zuku zuku. Giddy giddy giddy. Da 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 da. Shoko da go. He now sweat. He has wasted his time. Right after the oil for her, what she's to do? Go in your house, shut the door, because she's anointed, she's sanctified. When she goes to sleep, to take a document to go to a boyfriend place. Let go.
Clap for Jesus. Clap for Jesus.
Are you here? Are you here? Let's see. We different pastor. I can't preach for somebody's face. Oh, the gospel. Anyone come here will talk. Now, let one year. She after all the time pastor now waste on her. She going for embassy rather for interview in the morning. She goes to a boyfriend play. She play all kind of style here. What the hell? Show my hand, amen. Show my hand. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. You see? It's not like you. After doing all kind of... Watch now. Watch you. After doing all kind of thing here. All right? The pastor and there. Okay? But God sees that you have terminated the oil. You have desecrated the oil. And as soon as you play with the oil, the Holy Spirit has left. Amen? The evil spirit, wake up now. You take your phone. You do the embassy domo. Pastor, pastor. Pastor, pastor, pastor. The pastor of all. Raw power. No one can test your power. Your power is fresh from heaven. I'm going now, Papa. I'm going now, Papa. Papa, on my way now. Papa, Papa, I'm going now. Papa, Papa, on my way now. Papa, Papa, I'm going now. You feel it terminating yourself. Alright? Now, the men of God don't know. See you now. As you are going, the demons are cheering behind you. Are you ready to pray? Are you ready to pray? You sure? The demons are the ones escorting you to embassy. Not anointing you. Demon escorting you. Waiting for you there. Counselor, say my friend. Paper. In fact, like that counselor, we ask for paper. My friend. Time. Oh. He said, man, present. You present what? Go. Go, sir! Then you come on, sir. See yourself now. Who the people can hear in the ear? What power, what power. Am I talking right? What the people can hear in the ear? What the raw power, what power? They say, you can pray. What prayer now? I go to embassy to put me on, sir. You forget you were playing star last night. Hey, gentlemen. Eh? You forget. But you not share the blame on the pastor. You forget. There are people that are unaware for interview and they stop at the junction of the green flower. They are there. You go in Tuesday morning and Monday evening, you have the green flower. Tell your friends, oh, I enter down there. See the kind of thing you're talking. You go, yo. The pastor have been praying. You come here. So one more. Oh my people, let down my people here. Win the V. Win the V. Win the V. That TV will win. Who's supposed to? I don't know what to do. 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 To do, do, do. You don't know what to do? Eh? No problem. Bring it up, pray. And you ask so sorry for. Sorry for like the time you were 2 years old. When they meet you a fool, they saw you. Mama, oh, kolo, hey. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Are you getting me? Pastor, look, pastor will make a declaration. My daughter, my son, I see you on your way to the embassy. Let the anointing of an interview or whatever you are going for, let God, the pastor will waste his all. After wasting his all, go stop at the junction. A friend asks, you say, are you American now already? The beginning about an asthma. Give me water. Give me water. Another bottle. Let me show you. Another bottle. You not reach here. Oh. You even cross New York Junction. You not free pole. But you in the embassy already. So when you interview tomorrow, yes, who pray for you? Raw power. The main power raw. I can do anything. The power all over me. I don't get a problem with the power. But you know why? And the power you quench is all. Pastor Nano, and you now flip. And I see net. They will tell you whom. And the next Tuesday morning, so be at the embassy. Pastor, you know about it. But God sees you. I wish I was talking to only one person. Are you here? God sees you. Amen. God sees you. They told you drunk. And as they are carrying you home, the pastor in step last night. Shakaba, shakaba, shakaba. My favorite son going to the embassy. Shakaba, shakaba. Pastor slept praying for you. Where about you slept drinking? I miss you all the stranger here. Are you the first time coming? I miss you here. Wow. You're welcome. Now your day. Are you here with me?
Yeah.
Are you here with me?
Yeah.
Shakaba, kaba, 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 kaba. Your liquor clear at the hour of 8. The interview at 8:15. Your liquor clear 8:10. So when they get less 5 minutes between. In the interview, now they're asking you. Say, hey, you. Give me your passport. Fear or sin. Sin is a friend to fear. Sin. Anyone that lives in sin, lives in fear. No one lives in sin will ever live in fear. Once you live in sin, any problem come away, fear, you come and die. Fear, you come and lose your job. Fear, you come and lose your home. But if you have a life of God, no matter what come your way, you are stable. Because you know that it is God that gave. I'm not talking to somebody here. I'm not talking to somebody here. If you say amen, then you are hearing what I'm saying. Shout aloud. Say
fire!
Transgression. God, yeah, but God don't hear it. I thank you, go. And then at the end of the day, you say, oh, no, the man of God prayed for me. My prayer was not answered. I'm trying to tell you today the reason why many of us, our prayers are not answered. Why we pray? Because God don't hear sinner. God don't hear rebellion people. God don't hear rebellion people. Look at something again quickly and project that thing for me. Deuteronomy, quickly. Deuteronomy chapter 9, verse 7. Deuteronomy chapter 9, verse 7. I want you to mark the scriptures down. Deuteronomy chapter 9, verse 7. Deuteronomy chapter 9, verse 7. Look at this very carefully. He said, remember and forget not how thou provoked the Lord, that God, to wrath in the wilderness. For the day that thou didst depart out of the land of Egypt, until he came unto this place, yeah, what rebel? Yeah, have been rebellious against who? Against who? Against who? Listen to this. In Second Chronicle, the Bible says, for the people who are called by my name, He said, we humble ourselves and they will seek my face. So rebelliousness and being humble, God don't hear the prayer of the rebellion. He hear the prayer of the homo. So rebellious men don't pray. Rebellions is not far from being arrogant. Rebellions is not far from being proud. Because a proud man don't pray, an arrogant man don't pray. If you think you are too big in your heart, you are too big in yourself. If you think you are come to the place where you know both, you know everything. There are people that feed what they have and what given to them by what they know. God don't hear the prayer of the rebellions. Once you are rebellious, there are many of us as I'm talking, when they say arrogant, we are arrogant. We are rude, very rude. And I will tell you for the point of correction, many of us today, that's why we have the call of God upon our life. But there is a nature speaking in us, a nature from our Father foundation, and that is busy in your call. But there is a prophecy upon your life, but there is a DNA that is speaking against you. Why many people today can't embellish the promises of God? Because they are rebellion. Ladies and gentlemen, once you are rebellion, you can never inherit the promises of God. People think that God is, so I tell people, I say, listen, there are pastors who are in the sector. The purpose and essence of being there is to get money. But it is not every pastor that are there looking for money. There are people who are there, they are not come to look for money. I'm not talking to somebody here. Because when you seek ye first the kingdom of God, all other things will be added unto you. We have to give people the principle and the guideline. If you cannot accept the principle and the guideline of God blessing, I don't care who you are. In fact, the first thing, I don't want to know who you are, where you work, where you coming from. I'm the kind of person, I respect people, but I don't respect personality. I don't want to know what you have. I don't want your money. I don't need your anything. If you cannot follow the principle of God, no matter who you are, I prefer you go to Baba, I prefer you go to Nate Doctor. But God is a holy God. God don't take prayer from arrogant people. He don't take prayer from rebellious people. To pray is to be humble. To pray is to be humble. God resists the proud and gives grace to the humble. If you think you're too big for God, you have no essence of being here. If you think you're too experienced for God, you have no essence of being here. If your amen is lying, you are hearing my flow. You say amen, you are hearing my flow. Sit down. I dare you talk to me like that. Don't you know I'm the one that bought the chairs and brought it in the church? I dare you talk to me like that. We are the supporter for this ministry. I dare you talk to me like that. We are the contributor. Your contribution, your support, your money, all of y'all go to hell. And you tell the devil, say, I'll send you there. It is time. We shouldn't give individual change in the body of Christ. Because when you get people chains in the body of Christ, they take the glory of God. I'm not talking to somebody here. I'm not talking to somebody here. But when people get to church, when the bad chair, they want position. When the bad chair for people to sit, only because they get the position, they walk out, go and never come back. I'm not talking to somebody here. We live in a days where many of the leaders, many of the people we are putting in church position, they are rebellions. I'm not talking to somebody here. Say rebellions. Don't give prophecy for prophecy. They give prophecy because of what people can give in the church. These days, men of God don't see vision for nothing. They see vision, we see a dash. Vision, we dream, and vision, we dream, and vision. Anything people see now is attached to what? Money. And that's why no respect for church anymore. People are getting failure with the issue called church. When they come to the place of church, they kind of mockery, they kind of shame that pastors are bringing on church. The way cheap church have become, church not get respect because the pastor did not waste it. What's up? 2 for 5, 3 for 10. No matter how you like it, I'm not talking to somebody here. So today, no rules, no regulation.
People walk to church.
As soon as they see where they get popular place, eh? People gather there. They want to show their self. I don't want to bring the thing here. I'm the kind of person where to God that I even said, if you see the church get need, you bring it to the church, fine. Maybe you know the reason why. You love God and be a blessing. But where in the case where you look at one person in the church, today people are giving sinners position. Am I talking to somebody here? Am I talking to somebody here? If you get one money roll, people steal money from government, they bring it to church. They steal money from entity, they bring it to church. They steal money from places, and they bring it to church. And you take them, we're all asking their lifestyle, you get them position. You get them chair, they say that. You start finding way and honor to give them honor. What's that? The church in this republic around the world is dead. The church is dead! No more Jesus again. Jesus has left our churches today. We are a generation of people who are looked down on the common people and looking up to the uncommon people. I'm not speaking to somebody here, but it is time for you and I to raise up a new generation. If I bring cheer to church, it's a privilege for me. If I bring fear in church, it's a privilege for me. But there are people when they come to church, once they make contributions, they don't want to be talked to harshly. When they rebel, I see you talk to them, they want to change that church. I see you talk to them, they want to go somewhere else. There are people, how dare you be somewhere? You can't take discipline, you can't be disciplined. Why today Liberian got church by themselves? Because Liberian hate discipline. And God you serve is a disciplined God. You cannot be disciplined. God cannot be your friend. I'm not talking to somebody here. God will not spare the raw and spoil the children. I'm not talking to somebody here. If you must serve God, we gotta be disciplined. It's time to raise in our church the discipline of God. It's time to make people to know that it is not everyone opening church because they need money. It's not everyone want a gift. We are seeking the presence of God. We want the presence of God to come back in our country. In other words, to achieve it is to do the right thing. It's time to acknowledge Liberia. It's time to do the right thing. We might be struggling, but let us try. It might be difficult, but let us try. If I live a holy life, the Lord will make a way. Once I live a life that pleases God, He's going to make a way. You cannot be a drunkard asking God. You cannot be a homosexual asking God. You cannot be an adulterer asking God. It's time to break out of these things. If God must answer our prayer, it's time to visit our ways. Tell your neighbor, say, visit your ways.
Visit your ways.
Say, visit your ways.
Visit your ways.
And I hear you. And I hear you. You're not saying no. Say, visit your ways. Sit down. Hallelujah. 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 Okay, let me give you two things that sin does for you and I. Or sin does for you and I. Number one, the first thing you understand here, people feel like when you sin, you go free. No. When you sin, you don't go free. No. When you sin, you don't go free. Let me just give a little description that I saw from somewhere from my father or day. Give me that bottle. Give me that glass a little bit. Hurry. Okay? He said, this is how sin is like. Sin, no sin go unpunished. And point of correction, no small sin, no big sin. Sin, last sin. Are you here? I need four water bottles. Mumu. Amen? Okay. Watch this one. Okay? Drink some more liquor. The following day again, you turn around, turn around. You cause your oldest. I don't want to let you know how sins operate. Are you here?
Yes.
Now, you'll be, you know, sin, sin is a pleasure. You are enjoying it and you forget. And the player will catch up with you. Even pastor prayer, I can tell you from there. Are you catching my flow?
Yes.
What, are you angry with me?
No.
Okay, no problem. Now, watch this now. Okay, you just from church. Somebody brought the hustle in church. They got married in church. You can't say, you don't see no man. The man won't marry. And the man you see. Four. Watch this. Sin is a cup. Well, it's a cup. Sin is a cup. Does that sin work? Sin is a cup like this. Oh, are you witnessing me yet? Okay, I'll go by Isa. Are you here?
Yes.
Okay, now. Take a look at me now. No, wait. God is counting these things. Let me tell you something here. It's funny. I'm a kind of preacher. That's how I preach. But funny. Your cup getting full. Wait, your cup getting full. All right? You are living in pleasure. You are enjoying. You feel you're going free. You get doing all kind of things in life. And you feel nothing will happen to you. Cup getting full. Are you here?
Yes.
Are you here?
Yes.
Are you here?
Yes.
In your whole life, you are never getting nothing straight. All you get is to crook people before you get it. Are you here? Lepe lepe. You know that place you get to in sin, your conscience is gone. Are you getting what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That level you get to when you reach at that level, when you reach here, is when you can take all your clothes and your breasts showing around the street. I'm taking it, lepe, lepe. Amen. Wait. Let me tell you what sin can do, all right? No, I can't. I don't want to display it. Huh? But I'll try. What sin does is that, let's look at something here, you and I. Like, for you, when you see someone on the street, they are close up here to the junction. Yeah. Like this. Yeah. And a close here. You consider them crazy, but today, you know what happened? Their conscience is gone. For you, you can feel it. Say, hey, amen. What they get on the street at the for? But to the guy. Are you here? No. When you see, you say, hey, she didn't want spoiling woman who she had bring disgrace to woman. But yeah. See, a play for cost stopping. Is how far she has come. Sin has eaten all over. Sin don't recognize evil. When you are a sinner, it's when you just walk in people's home and look at a married man and say, I love you. The love I get for you, your wife and girlie. That's what sin can do. When sin has come over you, you will leave, you will come in the church and climb on the pulpit and go straight to the pastor. The love I get for you, I see her before. Oh, I can tell you for free today. We're living in a place where when you see a junk, at least if you not spare a junker, it's not a problem. But at least spare the man of God them. Spare them. Oh, Jezebel can spare. Jezebel can kill. In fact, the target of Jezebel is the man of God. When sin is over you, fear gone. What people scared of? Chima, a pastor Kroma. The pastor ain't shake you. You rub you on the pastor ain't shake you. There's a story a young lady told me. She said, yeah, I want to give you an advice. I said, go ahead. She was explaining, it's a game to play. She was explaining the thing like she was explaining just something common. Very enjoyable. She said, I know, she said one of her friend got four pastors. She had been initiated to three. Her friend got four, she got three. In fact, both were made that's their habit. That is their habit. They go anywhere. They see a man of God, they make it their target. They make sure they clear you. am I preaching? Am I saying something? Am I saying something? I can tell you for sure today. I can tell you for real. For sure, in the last days, the devil, that's what sin. when Satan allows sin to overtake you, no regard. Sin don't have eyes. How you move? Oh, sin don't recognize anything. See, at the age of 12, 13, 28, and you are abusing your mother, you are abusing your father, you are abusing your older sisters in the house. That's what sin does. Sins don't recognize. Sin get no distinction. Sin go to anyone. Because sin is a manipulation of the devil. Sin attract demons. Are you here?
Yes.
Are you here?
Yes.
And she was not proud talking. She said, but the other one away on her side. He loved my friend. But that one, you know, like, I said, hey, God, this shall more get saved from us. Save my soul. Save us. And to be true, we need your prayer. Hey, we need your prayer. The demons, they are not approaching the congregation, the altar. I like you, please. I like you. Thank God. To God be the glory. I have one telephone numbers. There are people come here. I have one telephone numbers. Thank God, everybody have known it. People will go to bed and they will sit down. I just want to be probably a young mature person, that's all. People will take their phone. Anytime you say like, yeah, I can imagine. I say what? then you will see no text. I say, hey. You know, the one I really like about you. Really? The one you like about me? That one, the pastor, you were clear? But the problem is, I'm not true. Am I to somebody yet? Am I to somebody yet? Oh, you don't want to answer me, eh? Many of you, yeah, I believe you try call me. I can't insult. I reason you. I believe many of you have a phone. You try call me. I can't insult for a reason. Because when you insult your phone, like your friend and my friend all of you all of day. I say, my friend, my friend all of day. I don't know whether you are here or you ready here with me. I don't know. Are your friend? Oh, are your friend? Let me your friend. Are your friend? Oh, all the zombo. Then you can't be friend with them. You can't leave. You can't spare any man of God alone. Look at all the freestyle passing around. But just one thing God raised up to bless people. You will clear that one too? You don't let you. Are you here? Are you here? Are you here? Sin! It has taken over the church. Today! We are lying in the middle of day. It has become a problem. Sin has covered the answer of God. I'm not talking to somebody here. I say, I'm not talking to somebody here. What sin does? As I'm telling you, the first time, the second time, who take the water from here? The third time, the fourth time. Give me that glass. Who took it? Where? In the beginning. Yeah. Jesus of Nazareth. And they are here running you. Give me that glass. Thank you. Okay? You know, the only thing I will tell you here, church, I will tell you the size of the cup. My cup may not be your cup. Your cup may not be my cup, but everybody has their cup. But watch this one here. That thing you're doing, and you feel nothing coming out of it. Nothing wrong. You'll live free. You'll go free. Watch this. Let me tell you a level you'll get to. You'll get to this level. My cup runneth over. When you see it, drill it down. That's the place you see mercy speaking. Second chance. Or your cup already full. From here, comment HIV can kill you? HIV too big. From here, comment malaria? From here, just a headache. On your coffin, just a headache. What sin does to you and I? Sin kill our spiritual life. Sin kill our spiritual life. And when God said to Adam, he said, you will die if you eat this thing. He didn't die physically, but in the spirit, you were disconnected from God. So ladies and gentlemen, why we need to fight against sin? Because sin killed our spiritual life. When you are living in sin, you can dream. When you are living in sin, you can see vision. When you are living in sin, there are things you can do. When you are living in sin, God can never be your friend. I'm not talking to somebody here. People don't recognize sin, don't think it'll be anything. We don't talk about it at all. But it's the one polluting the church today. Once you are living in sin, ladies and gentlemen, if I regard iniquities in my heart, if I regard iniquities in my heart, if I regard iniquities in my heart, the Lord will not hear my prayer. If I regard iniquities in my heart, the Lord will not hear my prayer. I'm not talking to somebody here. I'm not talking to somebody here. Proverbs 23:13. What did the Bible say? The Bible say, he that covereth his sin shall not prosper. Proverbs 23:13. He that covereth his sin shall not prosper. Ladies and gentlemen, but he that confesses his sin, if you cover your sin, if you don't sin, or you ask God to get you out of what you are doing, why many people today, no matter what they do, it can prosper. The Bible say, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, that sitteth not in the seat of scoffers and sinners. His delight is in the law of the Lord. In the law of the Lord do he meditate. He's like a tree planted by the rivers of water. He's like a tree planted by the rivers of water. He said, whatsoever he does shall prosper. You cannot prosper until you run away from sin and you run away from sinner. No matter what you invest into, once you are living in sin, it shall never prosper. No matter what you invest into, once you are living in sin, you are wasting your time. Somebody must say, I put my money in the thing. You cannot put your money in that thing, and you are living a kind of life, and you expect yourself to prosper. If you expect prosperity, you got to examine your life. Hallelujah. Many people today, I will tell you for free to end the service. Many people today, they are going around with their problems. They explain their problem, but they cover their attitude. They explain their problem, but they cover. And many pastors don't know. Most people that explain problem, they are the root of the problem. There are many women today who are running for homes, and they say, my husband can't sleep home. What was the cause your husband stopped sleeping home? She was not talking. She only said, my husband can't sleep home. He go out, he do the one. When all of us 10 years ago saw me, my husband was not in the house. One morning, you were not there, but I was just sleeping. I saw him coming back. What did he carry outside? Woman, when you get ready, you are a man. You today, I will mother you. Woman talking like that, like man, I will mother you. I told someone, I said, if you married a woman, there are three charisma you will find in her. Number one, to marry a woman that knows her voice. Because any woman with men voice, she will flog you. If you don't run away from her, she will flog you. Because her voice, you my pity, come here. I will mother you. Yeah, I will mother. A woman! A woman! You want a woman? Put a voice on scale. No voice. Any woman that talk like me, run. Any woman that can talk like me, act like les mains, frotte les mains, bite les mains, kick les mains, stomp les mains, boil les mains. So the one minute men are running. You got women are taking men place. All I want to say, I am a friend of testimony. She said, oh no, husband, go to the other husband. Why are they going? Why? Where are they going? Yes, I meant to make up bed for you. One more. You in the house. You three. Today, one of the letters complete. All the men, the women, their men are running from them. Why? And you will come to pastor. Pastor, don't know too. He sit down. Say, oh, you know, man of God, I came to you. The man, man, I wish crap. La la. Like your mother witch, not the man, man. The man, man, like be witchcraft. One makaba ajun tarabahaya. He that come for where he sin. If you sit and say, Pastor, my home is breaking. Pastor, please, before you pray for my home, you can see all vision, but I want the truth for my own home. The first thing, I know how to talk to my own husband. So I need grace to talk to him. But you will have that one on the other side. Pastor, let me tell you something. When I was young, I was involved into too much men bene. So, Nana, I can meet my husband. Hey, can I tell you something? If you meet your husband, he expects to be there. What kind of trouble here? Eh? No! That I marry you! They may pay money, pay a dowry to go tie you to. What kind of trouble I see here? They may pay money! For the other small money now, he's still will flog you. I'm not talking to somebody here. Oh, yes! And I need your amen. For the other small money. For the other thing, you mean me? Why? Fresh. You will see fresh marry. Fresh one. Fresh marry, and I want to say fresh, and then we got 6 months. 6 months, you stop me. I begin, you know, call, you know what call can do? 6 months, we're in trouble here. Eh? So you tell me, you put you on the street, to be playing home behind you for nothing. That's someone chicken, you eh? Yeah, you'll be clapping. I'm in dream. I'm coming back. Be clapping. I'm in dream. Hallelujah! A lady went to the bus stop and said, Pastor, I'm hoping for divorce. The pastor said, divorce? She said yes. The man said why? He said ask him. The man turned to the pastor. I mean, the pastor turned to him. He said, sir, why is your wife on the point for divorce? The man said, then the pastor said, my friend, she will give you some time. They make him talk. Happily, he has made vow to God. Many of you today that are in a habit, you are privileged to get married. And you are the reason why a man sleeping out. You are on your way to hell. It's not funny. I'm not funny. Yes, I ain't got a problem with that. But if you are the reason why a man walk out of his womb, why? Because the man said, wake up. He said, you can't wake up. Wake up. When you are eating a chicken, you don't know a certain hour of the night you're going to wake up. Eh? you not die, you sleepy, you are alive. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hey, wake up. Wake up. Wake up. And you walk in the church, you're sitting in the car. Give me the microphone and do the product above. My husband left for 6 months, 5 years. And I was there in the room in Kiba. And I heard that testimony. And the person said, he came out and he laid down near me. So I pray you won't lay down. So that tells you he have been wishing to lay down near you, even putting you on the ground. You go lay down Osana, then you can turn it to prayer point. When you misbehave, then you find foolish prayer point. My father, come back where? Who in the land need peace? Everybody looking for peace. Anywhere you find peace, that's where you find rest. I'm not going to somebody here. Shakata Labahaya. Spiritual love is dead. Am I speaking here? Are you ready to pray now? Let my mom run into my car. Shut it down now. Let me shut it down now. He that cover his sin shall not prosper. He that cover where his sin shall not prosper. Pastor, my weakness here is, to be honest with you, anytime the men say, you got to share something. Every day, if not the witchcraft, not the foundation. If some things are physical life, some things, if you're not willing to do it, don't get into it. Don't get into it. You're not trained for it. Don't get involved into it. Hallelujah. God kill you. Sin kill us spiritually. Sin separate us from God. Totally. Totally. It separate you and I from God. No matter how long you've been serving God. Once you are serving God, and in other words, at the end of the day, you start serving sin, God will leave you. Sin separate us from God. We become former Christians. Former pastor. Look at that pastor. He used to be strong. Look at that. I mean, I used to be in church before. I was a prayer band member. I used to be in the fast and prayer department. What did tell you from there? God hear prayer. But if I regard iniquities in my heart, God will not hear my prayer. He that cover his sin shall not prosper. Anything you do, you will never excel. Anything you do, examine yourself. Visit your life. Ask yourself. Go to your private closets. Shut some things down. Shut some things down. Go away from some activity. Run from some activity. Run from some things. False pastors and prophets will not eat your money. God can hear. But if you live a life he wants you to live, he hears you. Stand up if you really now. Clap for Jesus, whatever you are. Clap for Jesus. Clap for Jesus. Are you here now? I can hear you. Are you here now? I said, are you here now? Yeah, we're just trying to clear the way for God to hear our sin. Ladies and gentlemen, where there is no sin, there is no forgiveness. Forgiveness is the key to sin. The only key to sin is forgiveness and mercy. My God, I want to go back with a testimony. I don't want to be here all the time, coming here, going mad. Father, thank you. Who are blessed today? Let me see your hands. If you are blessed today, just clap for Jesus. Clap for Jesus. Clap for Jesus. Listen. Look at me. Look at me. One. Let me say something quick to you. Number one, you're my fathers. You're my mothers. You're my older brothers. You're my sisters. We're from the same land. We're from the same country. You know why I talk to you like this? Because I mean well for you. Somebody from outside, they won't talk to you. They won't tell you the truth. If we're going to excel in everything we do, let be bold. Let come out. Let hear. And let ask God for forgiveness. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I don't know what you're doing privately. You don't know what I'm doing privately. We don't know what we do privately. But we can visit it. I'm not talking to somebody here. If you pray, I'm not the one to answer you. If we pray, I'm not the one to answer you. is the right permitted to pray for you but not to answer you. It's God that answers people. I'm not talking to somebody here. So if we wrong him, we are not big to say, sir, we wrong you, we sorry, forgive us. We are human. Amen. Lift up your hands, whatever you are. Everybody lift up your hands. Everybody lift your hands. Say the prayer after me. Say, my Father, my Maker, in every way I've sinned against you. And I want you to pray the prayer like you are guilty. Pray like you wrong God. Pray like you want a testimony. Pray the prayer from your heart. Pray it like you accept that you are not big. You are not too proud for God. You are a human being. You can make mistake. And you are make mistake. And you want for God to correct it. Say, my Father, my Maker. Say, I pray. Everything that I've done against you, whatever I have done to hurt your heart, wherever I've gone against your will that caused you to go far from me, as I begin to pray, have mercy on me. Open your mouth and ask for mercy. Makabarandonza Ibaragadena. Everybody ask God for mercy. Ask God for mercy. Ask him for mercy. Ask him for mercy. The young men, the old men, the fathers, the mothers, the sisters, the brothers, ask God for mercy. Wherever I've gone wrong against you, have mercy on me. Forgive me. Come back to my life. Open your mouth and ask God for mercy.
We pray for your mercy to come. Your mercy to come, my Father. Your mercy to come, my Father.
Are you praying or you're talking? Open your mouth and ask God for mercy. Outside, in regular land, whatever you are, the God of mercy, have mercy on me.
We pray for the mercy of
God. Ask God for mercy. Come back to my life. 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 Wherever I've gone wrong against you. Wherever I've gone wrong against you. Have mercy upon me. Open your mouth and ask God for mercy. Everybody. Everything my family did to you. Whatever me and my family did to you. Whatever I and my wife did to you. Whatever I and my children did to you. Whatever I did to you in blessing. Have mercy on me. Ask God for mercy. Ask God for mercy. Shikabala. Where are all the mothers? Where are all the fathers? Have mercy for your children. Ask for mercy for your wife. Ask for mercy for your father. Ask for mercy for your mother. Ask for mercy for your family. Ask for mercy. Ask God 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 for mercy. You are not big to say have mercy.
Oh my Father.
In regular land, whatever you are.
My Father.
Open your mouth and ask God for mercy. Inside, outside, ask God for mercy. The church of my people is dying. Your people are dying. Your children are dying. We want you. Forgive us.
We pray for your mercy.
Father, forgive us.
We pray for your mercy to come.
Forgive us.
Your mercy to come.
Mercy.
father,
ask God to forgive you. Ask God to forgive you. Ask God to have mercy on you. Ask God to forgive you. Forgive me, forgive me.
My father.
Oh, mercy.
My father, we pray for the mercy of God.
Wherever I've gone against you, wherever I've been wronged against you, the God of mercy, the God of mercy, the God of mercy, I'm messing on Liberia, I'm messing on your people, I'm messing on your children, I'm messing on your sons, I'm messing on your pastors, I'm messing on the congregation, I'm messing on this nation, I'm messing on the members, I'm messing on your bonds, I'm messing on your Christians. I'm messing on the Christian community. I'm messing on us as Christians. We have gone wrong against you. We have fought short against you. We knew your mercy. Have mercy. We are human beings. We have fought short against you. Father, have mercy. Father, have mercy. Mercy.
My father. My father, look up. I pray, look up, my father. For your mercy, look up. 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 For your mercy, look up.
Mercy. Ask God for mercy. Mercy for the pastors. Mercy for the Church of Liberia. Mercy for the Christians. Mercy for your family. Mercy for your friends. Mercy for those that are in the hospital. Mercy for those in the prison compound. Mercy, oh Lord. The God of mercy. Have mercy. We wronged you. Forgive us.
Mercy, we lift up our voice to call to the heaven now. We pray for the mercy to come. In the Lord of the my father,
in Jesus' name.
Are you here? Listen to me. There are times in life, there are things we don't want to do, but we find ourselves doing them. I'm not talking to somebody here. There are nature of sin. There is a particular nature inside of us. I want you to know that everyone has a nature of mortality. There are things you may not want to do, but you find yourself going that way. You are a human being. I like what David said. David said, I was sharpened in iniquities. He said, and in sin did my mother conceive me. Many of us, we have the nature of sin. There is no champion, there is no spiritual giant. I'm not talking to somebody here. There is no giant. There is a particular power pushing you to sin. There is a particular force in you making to do what you are doing. I'm not talking to somebody here. The nature of sin in my body, you're going to say, catch fire. The nature of sin in my body, catch fire. There are many all we want to serve God, but sin can give a chance. Many all want to live a worldly life, but sin can give a chance. Many all want to be for God, but the world can give a chance. There is a particular nature in your spirit that is forcing you against the word of God, that is making you to rebel against the word of God. I don't know which part of your life that thing is. I don't know which part of your nature that thing is, but sin is a concept, and many of us, we are inborn tendency of sin. We have the sinning nature. The nature of sin inside of me, catch fire. The thing that makes me to do what I like to do, catch fire. The nature of sin inside of me, catch fire. Ladies and gentlemen, sin condemns you. Sin reduce you. Sin separate you from God. Sin make God to go far away from you. Sin make God can hear your prayer. So sin
Satan is man's greater enemy. Let your voice say, my father, my maker.
My father, my maker.
Pray with anger, my father, my maker.
My father, my maker.
Just begin to pray.
As I begin to pray.
Every nature of sin is out of me.
Every nature of sin is out of me.
I am a child of God.
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 Every nature of sin is out of me.
Every nature of sin is out of me.
Causing me to do what I don't want to do.
I don't want to do.
As I begin to pray,
But
fire,
of God for in you. See, if you can't see vision, you can't dream, and nothing that can happen to you, you can't feel presence of God anymore. Sin kill the presence of God from inside you, and it is the presence of God in you that determines the answer to your prayer. If you are home and when problem come, maybe you may not rush to the pastor, maybe your child may get sick, your husband, your wife, you're supposed to lay hand on the person and pray for them, and God will hear you. But by right, when you pray by yourself, even in your room, at least you must fall under God's presence. But if you pray in your room and you cannot experience nothing, no shivering, no cold, no nothing, it means that sin, it can kill the presence of God from in your life. I'm not talking to somebody here. Yeah, because Satan, he can't get at you until he take the presence of God from out of you. Are you here? Are you here? Are you here? So you men here, you are looking yourself, but you can pray something happen. You can pray somebody get delivered. You can pray and God hear your own prayer. I'm not talking to somebody here.
Yes,
that some of you here, you don't need, when you are going somewhere, or when you are somewhere, there is a place of evil, or there is a place of problem, when you pray, God hear you. But if not hearing you again, show concern. Father, we were friends. What's going on? He says, sin in you. When sin is in you, the presence of God leave you. When the presence of God depart from you, so trouble will follow you. Are you here? Are you here what I'm saying?
Yes.
Osa, can you hear me? Can you hear me? Yeah. Sin kills God's presence. For in you, sin, it killed the present. You can shave off. You're not shaving again. You could feel chill. You're not feeling it again. You could feel heat. You're not feeling nothing again. And you're not bother at all. Sin kill God's presence from in you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, I feel something here. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We shouldn't give him chance tonight. We shouldn't allow him to rest. Am I talking to somebody here?
Yes.
Lift your hands and say, my Father, my Maker.
My Father, my Maker.
Every attitude in me.
Every attitude in me.
That is killing the presence of God.
That is killing the presence of God.
For in my life.
For in my life.
As I begin to pray.
As I begin to pray.
Every attitude inside of me.
Every attitude inside of me.
Everything the enemy planted in me.
Everything the enemy planted
in me. Killing the presence of God.
Killing the presence of God.
Whatever I am doing on my own.
Whatever I'm doing on my own.
That is killing the presence of God.
That is killing the presence of God.
In my life.
In my life.
As I begin to pray.
As I begin to pray.
I may not know that thing.
I may not know that thing.
I may not identify that thing.
I may not identify that thing.
But as I pray.
As I pray.
Whatever that thing is.
Whatever that thing is.
In my body.
In my body.
In my life.
In my life.
Come out.
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 Open your mouth and fire prayer. Bring it out. Bring it out. Bring it out. Now, listen to me. If you check in many families today, in many families, people ain't get nothing to point at and say, this is for our family or for us. Are you here? We're going to take one prayer. Father, give me something to leave behind. Simple. Are you here?
Yeah.
Yeah. Lord, give me something to leave behind. Mind leave nothing behind. Mind leave nothing behind. Ain't it uncle, parents, descendant, ancestor, and you are coming out to you, not leave nothing behind. Father, give me something to leave behind. To let anything I put my hand in, let it show. Give me something to leave behind. I want you to pray that prayer like you are angry. Give me something to leave behind. Get a makabala shata. Say, my Father, my Maker.
My Father, my Maker.
I can tell you now, let this now, after you have confessed your fault and you pray to God, you clear the way, you pray, nothing can hinder your prayer. Are you here now? Say, my Father, my Maker!
My Father, my Maker!
Say, as I begin to pray!
As I begin to pray!
If you are a son, a daughter, a fellowship of this commission, don't take that prayer lightly. Pray that prayer like you are vest for your whole family. Father, give me something to leave behind. Amen. Now, $200 job. Three, give me an inheritance.
Oh, he said, ask and it shall be given to you. Seek and you shall find. We are about to ask, give me something to leave behind. The record that have not been broken in your family, you are the one that will break that record. What nobody has left behind in your family, something will be left behind by you. That your amen is not correct at all.
Where are the men? I want to see your hands. All the men, lift up your hands. I want to pray like Nehemiah. When you pray, let the Nehemiah anointing come on you. Pray like Nehemiah. The Bible said when Nehemiah heard that the walls of Jerusalem were broken down, he went and fasted and prayed. The Nehemiah anointing is a constructed anointing. What have been broken down in your family? Let God use you to build that thing up. Lift up your hands, all the men and women. Say, my Father, my Maker.
My Father, my Maker.
My Father, my Creator. As I begin to pray, give me something.
Give me something.
That You are here, look at me. I want to tell you one secret. Are you here? Church, I heard a lot of beautiful testimony that God is employing people in here. I have people come here who hasn't worked for 12 years, who hasn't worked for years, and God himself gave them job. What I started here, a jobless man in society is a condemned man.
Yes.
When you are jobless in life, one, family will condemn you. Two, relationship will condemn you. Three, people, environment, society will condemn you. Am I talking to somebody here?
Yes,
am I talking to somebody here? Yes. A jobless man is a condemned man. Am I talking to somebody here? Yeah. Many of our men today are jobless. Many of our men today are men with potentials and skills and talent, but no platform to display. People are employing those they are interested in. People are putting their interest into power, whereby potential men are wasting. You are not born to be wasted. I said you are not born to be wasted. You say amen. God will employ you in the next 24 hours. Shout out! Shout
out!
Joblessness bring argument in relationship. Joblessness bring disrespect to a father. Joblessness can abuse a man who. Are you here? It's time for men to go into action. It's time for men who are men of this nation to take their right place. Am I talking to somebody here? Yeah. Yeah. Jobless woman, a jobless man is a condemned man, a condemned woman. Once you don't have job, no respect. Am I talking to somebody here? No. Am I talking to somebody here? A woman who hasn't been into business, who is not doing business at all. I'm not talking to somebody here. People will always see you to be wasted. Yeah. If you're not doing nothing at all, people will always see you to be wasted. You weren't born to be a beggar. To eat is to ask people. To go to town is to ask people. To wash your clothes is to ask people. To do anything is to ask people. That time is over in your life and say amen today. Hallelujah. Men are giving men jobs. Amen. Men are giving their interest job. But you're going to tell God, God, I need employment for you. I need employment from you. Father, I need employment from you. Anywhere you put me, no problem. I'm not talking to somebody here. I'm not talking to somebody here. If we take the prayer today, Sunday too far. Don't doubt yourself. I've seen God doing it. I've seen Sunday too far. You say amen, God will give you a testimony. Gonna ask God, if you are promised to be employed, let the promises be fast. Amen. Anything you are promised and it is delayed, let God enforce it. Let God win the hearts of men. Let them call you and employ you. Let God touch the heart of men that are in position. You may not give a chance for someone to employ you, but you could pray to God tonight and God will touch the heart of great men and women. As God touched the heart of Darius, he didn't sleep until he sent for Daniel. God will touch the heart of your helpers. And they will call your number right after the prayer. You say amen, somebody will call you for job. You say amen, they will call you for job. If you can stand it, me, I can continue to foresee you. Our men being jobless. Jobless. Life is a condemned life. Are you here?
Yes, sir.
You are walking out of that life. If you are amen, you scream with amen. You are the one I'm talking to. Are you ready? Say, my father, my maker.
My father, my maker.
Pray it for yourself. Say, my father, my maker.
My father, my maker.
Pray it like
this is the prayer point you are waiting for. Say, my Father, my Maker.
My Father, my Maker.
Say, as I begin to pray.
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 Let the morning pass by me.
Let the morning pass by me.
Give me job to do.
Give me job to do.
Open your mouth. One more time. Ask God.
Something to do in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Wow. Shakabala zota la brahazata. My God, my God, my God. With my hands lifted over lives and over people, the God of this generation, show your power to your people. The God of this end time, he that make mention of the Lord, he said, give him no rest until he establish you. My God, my God, I pray for you. Whether you are inside, you are outside, whatever you are, I speak over your life. Today shall be a judgment day for your enemies. Listen to me. We have heard God doing marvelous things in people's lives. And the people you hear on our media, we don't know them. But they come here, they stay just right where you are. And we make pronouncement. And they believe God, and they walk away with healings. And they walk away with deliverance. God so much that this thing is not a problem. No, this thing is not a problem at all. I pray for everyone. Listen very carefully, because I am seeing in this public gathering, I'm seeing a lot of premature death. Wait. I want to pray for you, and I want to pray for your family. May the wrong people go down the drain, and God will keep all the right people there alive. If that's what it means loud, then you understand what I said. There are people want to pray for no reason. They want to take your place. That's why they are pursuing you to kill you. You know they are against your happiness, and they are against the good of God in your life, in your family life, in the life of your children. That's the reason why they want to kill you. But I want to make a pronouncement as a prophet of the Most High God. If God has said, hear me in 1 second. I pray for you wherever you are hearing me from. Is it not that man that I'm going anywhere to kill you? Is it man born by woman take measures to kill you? In the next 24 hours, they expire! Hey! They expire! Hey! They expire! I pray for you
go anywhere. I pray for you now. If it is in your system, if it is in your body, by the power of the living God, whatever the enemy puts in your system, anything they have inside your life, or anything they have in your body, whatever means they use to give it to you, I'm going to pray now. As I am praying, they are taking your property. Whatever the enemy have inside of you, as I begin to pray now, today they are taking it out of your body. I pray for you tonight. Whoever does not need the benefit from your labor, this prayer especially goes to the fathers and mothers who have labored behind their children and the devil coming astray. I pray for your belly bones. I pray for whatever came from out of you that the enemy said it will go useless. Whatever that want your children to go useless, today God make them aspire. I want that to amen the loudest. You say a louder amen the aspire. In the name of Jesus.